You know, in the Azim Premji University, which is one of the new universities that has come up, we have started developing a MA program. We already have a MA which is on development, but we are thinking of specializing in livelihoods within that. Okay, and if in the long run we might get into a MA livelihoods, but that's subject to the knowledge content being enough. So we have been thinking about this issue for some time. Now, when we started looking at the livelihood education programs, okay, before we did that, we wanted to understand, you know, what is this livelihood concept about and how has it emerged, what are the basic lineage of this whole theme. The labor maintained with the landlord is also not an economic function, but it does provide a huge risk-bearing strategy. So therefore, diverse functions include not one activity, not just agriculture, animal husbandry plus trading and all that, but not only economic activity, but also social, political, cultural, you know, lot of things together they manage their life. These activities affect each other, but it also, the other issue on which they drew attention to was the risk and the vulnerability faced by the poor households. Especially the group of economists argued that vulnerability for a poor household is sometimes far higher than just the risk as measured by the risk. For example, if a area acre of land was producing 4 quintals of food earlier, if the rainfall or the crop production falls by 10%, this 4 quintal becomes 3.6, which may not be enough to feed the whole family. Whereas for a larger farmer who has 10 acres, his 40 falls to 36. His savings come down, but he is not at a level when his life is threatened. So the vulnerability context, which is further multiplies for a poor household, is far important to be looked into. The other important issue that this group of people took out was the dynamic nature. They said none of these are frozen in time. These are changing constantly, and poor therefore have to face this. Now, we see the first thing that, again, this was partly the Amartya Sen's work, where he said that utility is not a univariable function. The utility, which has been our, one of the basics of our economics and the utilitarian theory and all that, man gets his satisfaction not from one thing, it gets from multiple things. Okay? So, and the, as I said, that the house has the unit. Now, these two things together, we have also said that the, it engages in a portfolio of activity, not one activity. The two other things have been that the capability concept, which again Amartya Sen had propounded, is again not something which is static, it changes. The son gets married, an extra hand gets added to the family, the capability of the family changes. Somebody falls sick, the total capability of the family changes. So it's, even the capability is not frozen in time. So are the resources and markets. So therefore, poor being more vulnerable have a far higher impact on the risk, which I have already talked about. So now this is what makes livelihoods perspective different from the poverty alleviation perspective or income generation perspective. Income generation was one activity. Let's look at that, how do I increase the return on the one particular resource, skill building for that particular activity, market linkage for that particular activity, etc., etc., etc. So So that was the approach which had been taken for the income generation paradigm. But having tried that method for quite some time, people started realizing that it's not working, and that's where this construct came up. And this has now become quite popular, where we have started looking at the household as a whole. So the word holistic has been used even in the past, but this gives us a different window of looking at the poor household and their income, etc. Now, in terms of the livelihood education programs, as we saw, therefore, I think needs to help participants build this perspective. They still, though use the titles of livelihoods, etc., have remained within the old paradigm of income enhancement, employment enhancement, and some of those kind of paradigms. Yes, within that, of course, there will be tools, techniques, etc., many of which are not yet developed. And that's where I think again academia needs to play a very important role, that how do we convert this, you know, this is a broad, this is a perspective, and what do I do with it? Converting this into something which is doable, which is instrumental, which can be learned by our students and be practiced on the ground is a very important goal which I think we need to give. So, I'll stop here. I think I've made my basic point. So the basic point that I've been trying to make is it's important for livelihood education programs to not become tools and technique training programs, but a perspective building program. Even if we are giving tools and techniques, possibly I am using the same market research tool. But if I have the perspective right, then in the market research, I wouldn't only ask that why are you using surf instead of a local soap or etc. I will also try to understand what are the compulsions of the household, why is it happening in a particular way. So that's what will be my current thought on what we should try to do in the livelihood education process. Okay. Focus on this perspective, which is multi-sectoral, multivariate, multi-utility,